The accountants call it the £90 million match, but for these 22 players, it's about the chance to perform at the top of their profession, about tales of glory for the grandchildren, and you cannot put a price on that. It's been a long 2-week wait since the semi-finals. Plenty of time to dream wonderful dreams and sweat through night terrors. It's a season in a day, 9 months in 90 minutes. Reading are boosted by the return of Jimmy Kebbe, who missed the last four matches of the regular season and the two semi-finals against Cardiff with a thigh injury. The flying winger has been one of the players of the season for the Royals, but Shane Long's 25 goals have been a huge factor in their success, and he is one of the most sought-after talents in the division. Swansea go with the same 11 which started the second leg of their semi-final against Nottingham Forest. Monk is okay after a stomach upset. Neil Taylor still suspended. Stephen Dobby was here a year ago with Blackpool as they beat Cardiff in this very fixture. Reading got the Barcelona dressing room. They'll have been looking for a little pot of Lionel Messi's magic dust. Whilst Reading hope they might play like Barca light, Swansea hope to play like Barca in white. Brendan Rodgers against Brian McDermott. Brendan Rodgers, of course, 23 games as Reading's manager. Brian McDermott, a dozen years at the club, from scout, under-19s, reserves, to the first team, replacing the man who he schemes against today. Phil Dowd is the referee, the 25th year of promotion playoffs. The 22nd time it's been a one-off final, the 16th at Wembley. There have been some classics: Charlton 4, Sunderland 4, Swindon 4, Leicester 3, Bolton 4, Reading 3. What will Reading and Swansea serve up in 2011? It's Reading in the blue and white hoops from left to right against Swansea City all in white. And Mark Bright alongside. Great atmosphere and great excitement.
Excellent. I love this day. I really do. Taking part in two of them. And obviously, been very lucky to win on both occasions. But the atmosphere inside the stadium is fantastic. Two really good teams. I'm expecting a few goals, to say the least.
First free kick goes against Griffin, who probably now falls into the veteran category. Reading's number two at right back, Andy Griffin, 32. The left back, Ian Hart, is 33. Nervous moment right from the off. And Shane Long's enthusiasm putting De Vries under all kinds of pressure.
He's just had a few words in there as well. And one thing you don't want to do is he's having a bit of a smile about it, but I don't want to panic your clearance, but be firm.
Whipped away by Swansea, from Swansea by Ashley Williams. Ledgerwood forward. Williams trying to cover. Long is there, suspicion of handball. Play goes on. Jimmy Kebe here for Reading, and the goalkeeper De Vries needs help here. Needs all sorts of help. And Williams away.
Two suspicions of handball there from Reading players, but referee no doubt played on.
Well, Reading right at it, right from the off, and Doris De Vries in the Swansea goal has already had a couple of nervous moments. Bounced high up onto the right shoulder of Ian Hart. Over from Gary Monk. Joe Allen to Angel Ranjel, Swansea's Spanish right-back. And De Vries will be happy just to have the ball under no pressure. Tate. Went forward from left-back, and here's Sinclair, first touch of the ball. For the top scorer, he went over the outstretched leg, and that's a free kick to Swansea. Mills, the Reading skipper, protesting.
Good play from here, Scott Sinclair. Attacks the centre defence. Matt Mills comes out, he's late with his challenge. He knows straight away, he's saying no, but it is a free kick. In a really good position.
Well, if the next 87 minutes are like the first three, we're in for a treat. Wait for the whistle, says Phil Dowd.
I'm not sure if Federici's had a touch of the ball yet. This is going to be a bit of a nightmare for him.
Is it Sinclair or is it Barini? Well, that one would appear to have been decided as Sinclair trots away from it. It's to be the Italian Barini. Barini for Swansea. Well, big relief for Reading.
Yes. You don't want your first touch when you're picking out the net. I mean, that's a suspicion of handball there. And then Kevin just puts this back into the box. You just see, that's fluff. And on that one there, that's a handball as well. Looks the same person as Shane Long on both occasions.
And held back for Swansea. Noel Hunt.
I think any game you start off at a big occasion, Steve, slightly nervous, and the thing is, it's just about, you know, not giving opportunities to your opponents. Free kicks in around the box, silly corners away, and just ease your way into the game.
Noel Hunt for Reading. Barini looking for a free kick, and he's got one.
Initially, thought he didn't really have hold of the ball. Barini didn't have in possession, but we know with Swansea, if they can get their rhythm going, their passing, they use the full width of the pitch. Two wingers who can run with the ball, Scott Sinclair and Dyer, they can have a big effect on the game.
Joe Allen and Leon Britton back to his goalkeeper. Putting quickly from Mills for Reading. Spread wide by Allen towards Dyer.
You can see they use the full width. Nathan Dyer pulls right out onto the right hand side. Scott Sinclair onto this left. And what it does, gives lots of space in the midfield for Dovey or Britton just to move into those areas to collect passes from midfield.
Ian Hart with the throw for Reading. Shane Long rather thought he had, but free kick given. Joe Allen has to stretch here, he's done well. Sinclair hammered by Griffin. Oh.
Well, fell down straight across there, lots of complaints from the Swansea players. But Andy Griffin just saw a bit of the ball there, thought it was a legitimate challenge. To think he got, I thought he got the ball. Phil Dow just getting rid of it, just, you know, calm it all down. I think he's going to give Andy Griffin the benefit of the doubt on this one. Speaking to Matt Mills, the captain, who obviously he's given one foul away. I know it's a high-pressure game. Calm yourselves down. That's probably the advice. The next one goes in the book.
If there's an area of concern for Reading defensively, it might be the pace of the fullbacks, or rather the lack of pace of the fullbacks against the undoubted pace of Dyer and Sinclair. And Griffin's got a yellow card.
Well, he didn't get the benefit of the doubt. Puts himself under pressure now. Oh dear. 84 minutes.
Sinclair will be licking his lips now.
What you would do as a wide man, I mean, the way I think the teams are set up as well, Steve, both teams have wide men who are good in possession with the ball. You know, Jimmy Kebbe and Joby McEnough, as I said, for Reading, and also Scott Sinclair and Nathan Dyer. So, should be, you know, attacking fullbacks.
Barini here. Good turn by Barini. Zura Kazanishvili with the clearance for Reading, finding Joby McEnough. That's a nice little run. Brilliant goal he scored at Cardiff in the second leg of the playoff semi-final to put it absolutely beyond Cardiff City. Here's Jimmy Kebbe, who missed that game. Williams with the clearance.
Well, he's missed the last six games, hasn't he, Steve? The four league games and the two playoff games, and he's such a big player for them. You know, he's a real outlet down that the right hand side, attacks the fullback, shapes in a nice ball. Let's see, he is a match winner. In his absence, Sean Cummins did very well though.
Griffin's cross was just too high for Shane Long, who might yet get another stab at this. Long's done well, he's found Hunt. Roger Wood just lost sight of it. Jem Karajan in for Reading. Okay. He's claiming a corner, and Phil Dowd is going to give them one.
Yes. I was really impressed with him in the playoff game down at Cardiff. Hurricane, good in possession, good energy, gets forward well. A really decent passer.
So Mills forward from the back along with Kizanishvili. Ian Hart is in there too. It's Joby McEnough with the corner. He will deliver better than that before the day is over. So I thought he'd been fouled there, and Phil thought so too.
Yeah, Joby McEnough. Said that, you know, set pieces are vital, and you know, we've seen Barini blaze one over, and then Joby McEnough and a corner, not even clear the first man.
Williams and Tate. Sinclair, Griffin there though for Reddy. Karachan. Tate's mistake has put Ashley Williams under a bit of pressure here. Reading have maybe settled a little more than Swansea in the first 10 minutes.
I think Williams is going, Ashley Williams, the centre-back for Swansea, has a big job, because I think he has to cover Alan Tate, because Kebe's got such pace. If he gets around Tate, he's got to be engaging him to stop the cross.
Tate's not a natural full-back either at left-back for Swansea. Neil Taylor, of course, suspended after his second-minute red card at the City Ground. To win another corner, but actually he's conceded a free kick.
Not renowned for his skill, is he, Griffin?
Well, he's been around, hasn't he, Andy Griffin?
He's absolutely solid.
Got some miles in his legs, that's for sure.
Yes. And you're thinking, well, one of Leeds' leading goal scorers. His opponent's got a yellow card already.
Yeah.
Give me the ball, should be saying. Bursting the balloons on the pitch.
Well, in terms of goals at the moment, that man, Shane Long, is one ahead of that man. Scott Sinclair, 25 to 24. Langhill forward for Swansea. Barini trying to get in behind, and he did. Couldn't control it, but he definitely got there.
And saw what he's after.
And he's, he's taken it away from the goalkeeper here. Kizanishvili has passed Barini over. Federici is down.
And you can tell you, Barini's getting a yellow card here. You cannot, in between the goalkeeper running and kicking, you cannot raise your foot to knock it out of his way. Kizanishvili as well might get a yellow for his clash with Barini.
They do, both. Barini and Kizanishvili. So the Italian in the book, and so is the Georgian.
Well, silly from both of them. First of all, Fabio Barini, you know, as Federici's trying to clear the ball, whether he throws or kicks, as that ball's in there, you cannot do anything. He's miles away from that one. But this is just a silly act. There, look. Every player should know, I mean, that's so theatrical. Every player should know that, you know, in between the goal, that's in the goalkeeper's possession till he kicks it. I saw years ago, I think it was George Best, who flicked it over the goalie's head and went to score. And he should know that, it's basics.
Gary Crosby might have done it once for Nottingham Forest years ago as well, but get away with it these days. That's a lovely ball from Mills, what a pass. McEnough, Hunt and Long in the middle, Kebe getting forward too. McEnough just dwelled too long there. So, moving forward.
That is so un-Swansea-like. I mean, Ashley Williams there. Keep going across the back four. Keep possession. Should have been Rogers. He's in the technical area, would say that to them. Build. Put in the confidence.
Nathan Dyer here for Swansea. Isn't it what a terrific job he's done at Swansea City, but he just couldn't get Reading going in his 6 months there.
Well, like players, it happens, doesn't it? You know, and this guy has got them going. You know, and been there a long time. And, you know, he reminds me, I know, similar to Steve Coppell. You know, didn't get too high when you're doing well, and if things go bad, didn't get too low, and be consistent.
Well, he would have worked under Coppell, of course, for many years at the Nevesque. Alan Tate, Verini. Well read by Kazanis, really picked up by Joe Allen here for Swansea City. Leon Britton. Got to be aware of Leon Britton's shooting from range. Joe Allen. Nice little interchange again. Nathan Dyer here. This is good football by Swansea. That is more like Swansea City. And then Joe Allen, a little bit too ambitious maybe, cut out by Griffin. Jimmy Kebbe, inside one, left Joe Allen, now he's running at Tate and Williams, still Jimmy Kebbe. Tate got a foot in, Karachan, lovely ball, Shane Long, knocking it up to the back post, too high for Noel Hunt. McEnough's there, Reading still have four forward for McEnough to aim for. Two white shirts around him now, and I think he's running out of play. Yes. He has.
You've got to say that Swansea got a little bit lucky in one situation there, but managed to get back and recoup, and that's the importance of this guy. Running with the ball at his feet, so quick, so dangerous.
He was signed by Reading in the transfer window of their relegation season from the Premier League. A while to settle into English football, I think, but he's certainly done that now. Tate knows what it's like. He is on the ball. Swansea's left back knows what it's like to miss the deciding penalty in a shootout in a playoff final. That for Swansea against Barnsley in 2006 at the Millennium Stadium. League One playoff in those days. Jimmy Kebbe. Bit of room here, Jen Karachan into it. Deflection on the shot, might have carried anywhere. It's not away to safety yet, though the linesman on this near side has put his flag up.
Just the space he created, Jimmy Kebbe. Drew two men over. Takes a deflection off Ashley Williams. The ball inside, Osmond comes out, confronts it, looks like he hits him on the thigh. This is just that's a silly foul, that is. Noel Hunt close the ball, pulls his hands behind his back, very brave.
Reading lost both the league games against Swansea, both of them 1-0. Barini's little flick on, Kazanis really through to Federici. It's come off the defender. Hands behind the back, says Phil Dowd. Certainly was Gary Mott. Here's Mills to Griffin. Long. Ian Hart. Well, Hunt was offside anyway.
I tell you what, he did ever so well just a few months ago. Managed to keep that in. There's any question, I think it hits Monk, but I don't think he's trying to do anything other than pull his arm out of the way. Let's see. Just hits it.
I don't think you could say he moved his arm in the direction of the ball.
It's supposed to be intentional, isn't it? Phil Dowd had a good position. There was no intent there whatsoever.
Ian Hart with his throw in for Reading. Edward immediately looking for Jimmy Kebbe. Take back pedalling now. Ashley Williams has been pretty busy at the back for Swansea. It's his clearance again. There's Federici.
That's twice that is.
Is Joe Allen nicely away from Cem Karacan. In towards Sinclair, chance here, missed it. Kazanishvili across. Did well Kazanishvili. Sinclair was stretching slightly as he tried to get the shot away, but Joe Allen's won it back. Here's Tate. Dyer, good turn, and still, how about it? Phil Dowd says yes! Kazanishvili on Dyer, penalty kick. Well, Kazanishvili has already had a yellow card and he might be in trouble here.
I'm just wondering whether Phil Dowd thinks the penalty is punishment enough, but is it a clear goal scoring opportunity? Because I think Kazanishvili is the wrong side who makes the challenge. Now, to be fair to the Swansea players, they haven't kicked up a fuss about it.
Well, this is a really big moment in the game. Swansea City with the early penalty kick. And it's Sinclair. Scott Sinclair against Adam Federici. 1-0. Swansea in front.
Wow, the Reading players are surrounding Phil Dowd. I'm not too sure what they're complaining about. It looked a penalty to me. Kazanishvili actually gets the wrong side. As Nathan Dyer tries to strike the ball, I think his leg gets in contact with Nathan Dyer. There's no question about the penalty. It's very composed. Along the deck, sends the keeper the wrong way. Always a nice one. But this is the incident which gives the penalty. Kazanishvili there. Well, it's a penalty. It's an absolute penalty. He stops Nathan Dyer getting a strike and at the ball. There. I cannot see what the Reading players are complaining about. It's a stonewall. And if anything, he's lucky to be on the pitch.
Well, it's a big call for Phil Dowd not to book Kazanishvili. His only other previous game on this ground, Mark, was the League Cup final between Manchester United and Aston Villa. Remember it? He gave Villa an early penalty for a foul by Vidic. Didn't send Vidic off. Manchester United came back to win. Bit of groundhog day for Phil Dowd. But here comes Swansea again. Barini in the middle looking for the pullback from Dobby. It's Sinclair, it's two! Two in 2 minutes, and both for Scott Sinclair. And Reading have a mountain to climb now.
I can't believe it. Smacks of yesterday. Peterborough and Huddersfield, two in close proximity, and they cannot believe it. It's a neat finish from Scott Sinclair. This is the all-important ball here. Touch, away you go. I'm just going to say, it's not doing so wide. This here, and Griff comes to close the ball, and there's not much he can do about it. But there, look at Ian Hart, he's miles away. He's lacking the pace to get there. Lovely ball. Poor goalkeeping for Federici, lets it go.
Really good play by Dobby. And Sinclair. Still exhilarated by converting the penalty. He's on cloud nine as he tucks away number two.
Wow. In what, 22 minutes gone? Scott Sinclair is on a hat-trick. I can only think of one of the players who scored a hat-trick in the final here. And that's Clive Mandonka.
And that was in a 4-4 draw. Charlton finally went through on penalties against Sunderland. Well, Reading have lost a playoff final from 2-0 up. Now they will have to come back and try and win one from 2-0 down.
Well, the benefit is they've got plenty of time. It's not a scramble at the end of the game and just compose themselves, because one goal gets them back in the game.
Well, back in 95 they were 2-0 up against Bolton with only 15 minutes to play and they lost.
I don't know how long it was between the goals, Steve, but it knocks the stuffing out of the Reading fans, that's for sure.
75 seconds or thereabouts between the two Sinclair goals.
It's unbelievable for the Swansea players and for the fans, the management. It's fantastic because it doesn't half give you a lift. For the Reading fans, it's where do we go from here? And as I said before, they've got the ability in the team, there's no question. And the composure to do it, to get a foothold in the game.
Shane Long furious with himself for giving the ball away. Swansea City in the box seat. Brian McDermott's team with it all to do. Leon Britton here, dispossessed. Noel Hunt looking for support. Griffin getting forward. Sinclair back helping out. Phil Dowd says play on, given away by Tate. Hooked on by Sinclair. Mills now, Griffin. Nice little ball into Ledgettwood. Still Ledgettwood, shrugging off Joe Allen. Looking for Jimmy Kebbe. Need something quickly here, Reading. They've got a corner.
You need to be careful, they don't gamble everything. It just looks like Kerrigan and Ligatwood were both in the penalty area there. If that ball breaks down, there's no protection for the defence.
Ian Hart to deliver this corner. Kazanishvili looking to make amends. Nowhere near him. Back enough. Ledgettwood. That's a decent ball. Williams got a head on it. Oh, good strike by Mills and a really good block too by Barini. Karachan's won himself a throw in off Dyer. Well, for the best part of 20 minutes, there'd been nothing really to choose between the sides. Suddenly there's two goals and a chasm between the two.
So look at the Reading players, sort of in their frustration, kick the ground, bang the ground with their hands.
Leon Britton for Swansea, Manhill. Sinclair had come short, the pass went long. Well, 20 past three was a very bad time to go and get a cup of tea for a Swansea fan.
Imagine coming back. Did I miss anything?
Just a bit.
Oh, play on. I'm surprised by that.
Karachan's header only into Leon Britton. Jimmy Kebbe will leave it for Karachan. Kebbe now, Ledgettwood. Chased by Dobby, and Dobby's presence maybe meant that Ledgettwood gave it away.
And the thing is, lack of pace on the ball from both Jimmy Kebbe and then Ledgettwood.
Dobby, it was a great break by Dobby for the second goal. Really, really excellent piece of play.
It was just how to expose a space in the defence. That space between Ian Hart and Kazanishvili.
Noel Hunt back to Griffin. Reading corner. Mills and Kazanishvili and Ledgettwood and Hunt and Long all lurking in there. Ian Hart to try and get it to the near post. Not a bad idea, that. Noel Hunt flying in.
Too good a header. Lovely ball to the near post. There's lots of space in front of everybody. Pushed back out, left all the space to attack. He gets there first. Look at all the space. Get ahead of your man. And if anything, he just needs a little touch, just a skimmer, to take it across the goal.
They're
Reading lacking composure at the moment, you know, just need to get themselves together again. They've got enough experience in the team to keep talking to each other, get themselves together and start to play. Because everyone's been in a situation where you've been 2-0 down, or everybody as players, and you just have to just hang in there and look for that one chance.
What they mustn't do, you would think, is go 3 down. Sinclair running at Griffin, it's a goal kick. Yeah.
They just pick up the pace, the passing a little bit crisper in midfield. Carrican's really important for them, getting it going. Makinoff, now he's got a big job on his hands. You know, Jimmy Kebby, we spoke about just coming back into the team, what a lift it's been for the players and for the fans. But you need to give him the ball, get the ball to him and ask him to take on Tate.
Swansea are very good defensively. They only conceded 11 goals on their own ground all season, which is the best in all four divisions. I know we're not on their own ground, but they do have a 2-goal cushion. Just 2 years ago, Reading were beaten in the playoff semi-final by Burnley. Is it going to end in disappointment for them again? There's an hour to play, but they need a foothold in the game. For Swansea, looking for Barini. Got two bumps in the back from Mills. Wrote them well, and he's played it nicely into Dobby, who's Ledgerwood for company now. Sinclair. Dobby and Barini in the middle. Sinclair. Oh, he's done well. Barini on the turn. Oh, Kazanishvili backing into Barini. Not in the mouth for a moment.
Was intelligent play from Barini. Started off the move and almost got the final touch to it. Nice feet here. Just slots it into him. Good turn. Here, what you need to do is just get your body between the ball and Kazanishvili. Make him foul you.
Jimmy Kebe's cross. Oh, hell with the clearing header. Nathan Dyer.
It's a push.
Oh, he can't get away with it if it was. Here's John Karachant for Reading. Hunt wasn't expecting that, but he's brought it down and controlled it well enough, and then Kebe made a bit of a hash of the second chance to cross.
Well, missed a lot of football towards the end of the season, and say that this is a poor goalkeeping mistake myself. Ball goes slightly under his hand, and you know, push it away from the danger zone if you can. Reaction of him, De Vries.
Despair for one goalkeeper and delight for the other.
No goalkeepers union there, was there?
Downward header, back enough. That's nice.
Great play from Dale.
Legendwood. Just pounding in behind.
They're giving the ball away far too easily, Reading.
Leon Britton in quickly. Just got there in the nick of time.
Getting lots of reaction from the Reading fans and the Reading players. I think it was a fair challenge. I don't think there was anything in it.
Joe Allen here for Swansea. Alan Tate, good running by Barini. In the middle at the moment, Barini will hold it up, have a little look, have a think, give it to Sinclair. Tate is tucked it inside. Leon Britton, Stephen Dobby, Leon Britton again. Back to Britton.
This is what Reading are doing. Don't give themselves enough time to get a shape to move forward because they give the ball away too quickly.
Dyer, Sinclair.
Good stuff.
It's a little bit early for Olays. Tate. Williams. Right to Rangel. There's Ian Hart. World Cup, Adam Federici, Reading's goalkeeper. And this study to Mark Schwartz of Australia.
Well, I think that's a foul.
Back enough. Hard. Mills. Long. And it's put behind by Williams. Long hasn't really had a sniff yet in front of goal.
No, Gary Monk and Ashley Williams have done very well in the centre of the Swansea defence, and that's what you can see there. Now Long saying to Phil Dow, I'm getting held, I'm trying to hold the ball and I'm being held myself. You know, I do a little bit of sympathy with him on those occasions, but sometimes try not to get back up against the defender, move in between the two defenders and try and run across them.
Gary Monk for another corner, it would be a great time for Reading to get one.
Just got under it a little bit. I think what he's saying is he's been blocked. This goes on for every set piece. Players get quite close to each other. And what happens is, as you're trying to run past your opponent, somebody else blocks him. Gives you a free header if the delivery is good.
Reading's corner again. For Legendary to really get over it. The goalkeeper came and just about got there in the end. It looked like a poor decision for a second. Well, that's not a great header from Jimmy Kebbe. Here's Leon Britton for Swansea. Helped it on towards Drobby. Kyle did well. Ian Hart. Very Hunt. Hit it well enough and it hit Williams.
Yeah. Just under the ribs.
That's Joe Allen. Kazanishvili. Tate's put it away for a Reading throw. Yellow card for Mac enough for the earlier challenge. It's three now in the book for Reading.
Well, I think Phil Dowd got that right. waiting for the opportunity for the ball to play.
Griffin.
Not good enough, not good enough by a long way. He's headed a few balls and passed a few balls, a couple over the back of the bar, and yes, he's been out for a while, but you know, this is such a big game, you know, a little bit more care on the ball.
This is what he got the yellow card for, I think.
Yeah, tracking back, you know, it was late in Britain. Oh. Spot on, and you know, we complain about the referees blowing up and booking, but you know, he's trying to let the game flow. Full down.
Dyer. Kuzanishvili away, chance, it's three, it's Dobic, and it might be all over before half time. And I'm afraid Reading will look at Federici again. Stephen Dobby for Swansea, who lead by 3-0 with not even 40 minutes played.
Oh, he needs to get up on his feet quickly. What's the pace again, isn't it? Dyer goes past Hart. There you go, down the side, pull back. But this here, Kishnishvili just sticks a right foot out, just outside the right foot. He's gone past the ball, so he's trying to just flick it with the outside of his right foot away from the danger area. It just goes to the edge of the 18-yard box. Keeps his eye on the ball, nice and firm. A big ass now for Reading.
Had a huge target to aim for, Dobby, still tucked it away really well. And it's been an awful first half for Reading. Ledgerwood. Zurab Kuzanishvili is having one of those days.
Well, many ways you could say, should he be on the pitch, you know, it would have been booked and then given away the penalty. And what a huge half-time talk now, Brian McDermott.
Well, disbelief, I think, amongst some of the Reading supporters. And there's the man. John Nadeski, what will be racing through his mind now? Nathan Dyer for Swansea, good tackle by Mills. Sinclair. Kripke.
Again, just a simple pass, 6 yards, simple pass to Carrigan's feet, gives the ball away.
Dobby, free kick.
Frustration, Shane Long, can't get into the game. What are your thoughts?
Wood with a header for shallow shot to Reading. Dobby, to Britton, to Dyer, to Van Hell, to Monk. To Alan Tate. Sinclair's onside here. Allowed to turn Sinclair and find Dobby. Shot hit Kuzanishvili. Ledgerwood's there. Nobody any chance.
It doesn't. And you're flogging your forwards as well. It's very difficult for them. I mean, Shane Long puts his thumb up to John McEnough. He just shows signs of frustration. And what you can see, the difference between the two teams, Swansea, how they keep the possession and work it across the pitch, trying to find the free man at all times. Reading is one pass, two pass, and trying to hit the front man. Big difference.
Griffin. Kazanishvili. Hart. There have been some mighty comebacks in this fixture, but nothing quite like this. Swindon lost a 3-0 lead against Leicester once, but they did actually go on and win 4-3.
They've got a mean defence, haven't they, Swansea?
Jimmy Kebe. Surely three is a step too far. Jem Karachan for Reading. Given away by Joe Allen. Karachan's ball in is a good one. Oh, Long's missed it. Top goal scorer, the man most likely, Shane Long, 3-4 yards out, missed.
What a ball. Fantastic ball. He just looked surprised that everybody missed it. And when you've scored as many goals as he has, I mean, look. Oh, dear, it's painful to see. That could have just given something to go in at half-time. And hang on, Swin missed a couple of really good opportunities down at Sellers Park. Against Crystal Palace, I mean, that's an open goal, isn't it?
Well, his goals, you could say, have got Reading here. Ooh. Oh, well, how happy is Federici to have that in his gloves? 3 added minutes and we're into it. Well,
just wondering if it's just having to think of a change. I have to say, down at Cardiff, Sean Cummings, who played on the right hand side instead of Jimmy Kebe, played really well. Unfortunately, loses place. It could be an addition. But they're losing the midfield battle, Steve. You know, they're not on top by any measure in the midfield, and that's where it's going to be won. Passes. I mean, Kovacic just puts his head in his hands in the technical area. You know, you've got to go across to Lidgetwood, to Mackinnock. You know, use the midfield, link it with the forwards. Unless that long ball there is successful, just give the ball away. Or it's a challenge ball all the time. Once again, great turn of pace. It's a poor clearance, but it's a lovely technique. And I can tell you, in his wildest dreams, he never thought they would go in at 3-0 at half-time.
Hunt for Reading. Took his eye off the ball. And here's Ledgerwood for Reading. Chance here. Strong hands by De Vries.
Good strike. And very few shots on target they've had, Reading.
And Reading also look like conceding every time Swansea come forward. Here's Sinclair. Away from Karachan, Sinclair looking to take on Griffin. Dyer! Kazanishvili's there. Ledgerwood for Reading. Joby McEnough. Long. Unfortunately, attempted cross cleared away by Alan Tate.
Covering from Tate. I mean, Shane Long's had very few touches of the ball and he's very dangerous with the ball at his feet. Good shot here.
To corner.
Need to take it quickly. Something to hope to go in at half time.
Fifth corner. Enough takes, and De Vries takes it ever so easily. And the referee blows his whistle on a nightmare half for Brian McDermott and Reading. And Swansea City surely have one foot in the Premier League. Sinclair with two, Dobby with the other. Reading nil, Swansea City 3 at half time. Phil Dowd talking to Jay Tabb, the Reading substitute, and Lee Mason, the fourth official, now talking to him. Jay Tabb was sent off at half-time in the tunnel for foul and abusive language, and Lee Mason and Phil Dowd have told him he cannot sit in the dugout to watch the second half. Jay Tabb sent off at half-time. Well, Brian McDermott must have tried to give the half-time team talk of his life, because Reading will have to mount one of the all-time great comebacks to get themselves into the Premier League now. They must do, Marcus, start the second half strongly.
Well, we're just talking at half-time. I don't think anyone can believe the scoreline. And the important thing is, you know, Brian McDermott just go in there and give the players some belief that everything they've worked for now, the next 45 minutes are crucial. Get a foothold in the game, try and get something, get a goal, a penalty, something to be positive about.
Ian Hart with the throw. Long back to Hart. Swansea's throw. Rangel with the throw. Woods header straight out of play. Hale's given it away. Yeah, Britain trying to win it back. Referee says play on, and Noel Hunt touches it into Jem Karachan. The shot cannoned off Ashley Williams' left foot. Ledgertwood forward. Offside in the middle.
Just the things that McDermott would have probably said to them, that, well, have we created enough? Have we put their defence under pressure enough? You know, have we worked hard enough? Have we chased? If he was sitting in the stand, probably getting a better perspective higher up in the game.
Good ball by Rangel. Dobby on the turn. To Jem Karachan, here's Ian Hart now for Reading. No chance for long. Body check there. Ready Monk.
Need to press higher up the park, Reading. I'm surprised that they haven't come out and put the defence under pressure straight away, because I think that, you know, you put the defence under pressure, they may just give you an opportunity in front of goal as opposed to down the far end of the pitch.
Kazanishvili. Not enough. Didn't see enough end product from the two wide men in the first half, Makanoff and Jimmy Kebe. Here's the man down the right-hand side, the latter of those two. Kebe running at Tate. And Williams behind for the corner.
Well, you just saw far Alan Tate backed off there. Because, you know, defenders are frightened of pace. He needs a little bit of help there from Joe Allen in front of him. And Jimmy Kebe, as I said before, is a real key player. But he's got to drive at the defender. And the set piece has got to be a lot better than they were in the first half.
Great left foot, Ian Hart still possesses. What can he do with this corner? Deep towards Long. Put behind for another one. The blue and white hordes of Reading behind this goal. Back enough with the corner. Flick on, it's in! It's Hunt! Just what the doctor ordered for Reading. Noel Hunt with the near post header. And they just might be back in this.
Well, he did exactly the same in the first half. Remember, he got in front of his man and he headed it too strong. And it went wide. On this occasion, it's absolutely perfect. Just sneaks it off the front of the forehead, just down, nobody on the post. We always talk about people on the post. The ideal start for Reading.
Well, we just might have a game after all. Reading 1, Swansea 3, Noel Hunt right at the start of the second half. Doubts now in Swansea minds. Hope renewed and energy renewed in Reading. They had their warning in the first half, they didn't heed it, and this time Noel Hunt's header was spot on.
It was a lovely touch, it was a better delivery. I was just surprised that they left all that space in front of the near post like they did in the first half Swansea, because you put one player in front of that near post, he blocks everything off.
In towards McEnough. Reading suddenly with a bit between their teeth, and Swansea suddenly having to scrap on the edge of their own penalty area. So we talk about scrapping, that's Mills and Barini.
Both managers in the technical area now, and just, you know, from Brendan Rodgers, he would be saying at half-time, what a great start, we've done ever so well, 3-goal lead. Do not give anything away at the start of the second half to give them encouragement. Those words would come out of his mouth, guaranteed.
Here's Williams. Griffin. Hunt. Suddenly blue and white shirts racing forward. Williams didn't really get a good contact on that. Needed help and got it from Leon Britton. Here's Rangel for Swansea. Williams, Alan Tate, Joe Allen. Slipped by Barini, was ill-timed, here's Griffin, Hunt.
Positive.
Kebe, running at Tate. It's a corner.
We can take a look at the goal, it comes into the near post, and there, it looks like Hunt gets the touch, but the final touch comes off.
It is, it's Joe Allen, isn't it? It's an own goal.
Dear, dear, dear.
I think that's going to have to go down as a Joe Allen own goal. Reading corner. Mills touch too high, too heavy. Well, Joe Allen won't want it, that's for sure. But I suspect that the Swansea midfielder will be credited with that as an own goal. Ledgerwood. Ooh, that's a very strong challenge by Joe Allen on Noel Hunt. And Noel Hunt is absolutely livid. And the referee, Phil Dowd, is on the spot very quickly and has done a good job there, because just for a second, Noel Hunt had lost it. It was a really poor challenge by Joe Allen.
Yeah. I know what that might be, a little frustration at scoring the own goal. No doubt about it. The next name in the book.
Noel Hunt is being told by Phil Dowd to let the referee make the decisions, but here's the card.
Well, not his best few minutes. Justified, not there's any question about that. The rain's been falling, it's light drizzle. Surface is wet, but it's just a late bad tackle.
McEnough, a little slip, back to his feet quickly to try and wriggle away from Dyer. Ledgerwood back into McEnough. First touch was a bit heavy. Joe Allen across quickly for Swansea. They're rattled.
Yeah, just a little bit, lost the composure.
Taken quickly by Ian Hart to Ledgerwood. Long back to Ledgerwood. Now Leon Britton. Barini for Swansea. Definitely onside here, Dobby. Sinclair's charging up the left-hand side. Dobby's seen him. Dobby might go alone. Still Dobby's done brilliantly. Oh. And then he's put it wide. and so wide it might go for a throw. It has.
Well, he's done ever so well. I mean, does ever so well. Good ball, onside, no question about it. A quick look up, top of the screen, Scott Sinclair's running in for his hat-trick, but he just thinks, well, I can go it alone. On this, he gets a little ricochet here, goes in his favour. I mean, look at Scott Sinclair, he is begging for a hat-trick. But Dobby's done ever so well to get in this position. Comes off his heel, his right heel.
How important that chance.
Oh, dear.
And Stephen Dobby is being replaced with 10 minutes of the second half played by Darren Prattley. The man who scored from the halfway line in the last minute of the second leg of the semi-final against Nottingham Forest to absolutely seal Swansea's place at Wembley. Dobby did everything right, Mark, but yeah. Then the shot was... Well, throw
it. It happens sometimes. You just slightly take your eye off the ball just to see the keeper's position, and as you strike it, it comes off the heel. And it just doesn't go in the direction you want it to. As you said, quite rightly said, it went for a throw-in. You know, but he's scored on a made one, hasn't he? So he's contributed to that 3-0 lead prior to half-time. Well, you can see his instruction there was to come on and tell everyone to calm down. Slow the pace of the game down, let them get their passing rhythm going again, because they've hardly kept the ball this second half, Swansea.
Mills for Reading. Long with a flick on, Noel Hunt. Chance here, Jimmy Kebe! Oh, good defending, really well covered by Alan Tate, it's going to be a corner.
Well, good play from the three forwards there, first the flick from Long. Then Hunt just as it helps it into the box and Kebby comes onto it. I think he takes one touch too many, narrows his own angle, but they've won a corner.
They scored from their last. Looking off. Free header, it's in! It's in! It's 3-2! And it's the skipper, Matt Mills! One goal is an advance, two is a charge, and Reading are on the charge! It's 3-2!
Well, the position where we're sitting now is rocking because the Reading fans just behind us are just jumping up and down. What a delivery, what a fantastic header, because he's right at the top of his jump and he just guides it into the far corner. Beautiful header. Game on.
Matthew Mills, Reading captain, Wembley winner in 2008 with Doncaster Rovers against Leeds United. And look at John Medeski.
Well, it just gives them hope, doesn't it? At 3-0, at half-time, majority of people where we're sitting just saying, oh, it's dead, it's over. But, you know, the strange games I said to you about Istanbul before, and you just have to believe, get back into the game, and it gives the fans belief in the team. As you said before, Swansea looked a little bit rattled in the second half.
And here's Prattley. And now Barini, good turn, still Barini. Great play by Barini, then he just couldn't pick out Joe Allen.
And options, didn't he? Sinclair was there, Allen was there. Great feet from Barini. They just need a few moments now, Swansea, where they can just gather themselves together because Reading are on the rise.
And Jem Karachan's running right at the heart of their defence and he's claiming a foul, he's not going to get it. Well, we said right at the start, there have been some absolute classics in this game over the years. Charlton 4, Sunderland 4 in 98. Swindon 4, Leicester 3 in 93, Bolton 4, Reading 3 in 95, Ipswich 4, Barnsley 2 in 2000, not forgetting Blackpool 3, Cardiff 2 12 months ago. This, Mark, might be the daddy of them all.
Well, I mean, you still think Swansea can score. You know the pace they've got up front and the movement they've had. And we just talked a few moments ago about Stephen Dobby's miss, how important might that be? I mean, but the Reading fans now, obviously, rocking, but Swansea just not picking up, too much space. Initiatives with Reading.
Nathan Dyer. One back by Mackenough. Into Shane Long. Long playing it off to Jem Karachan. Shooting chance off the post. It must be. Hunt, it's blocked brilliantly. Monk got in the way. I don't know how. What an opportunity. Noel Hunt. Karachan hit the post. And Hunt hit Monk.
Wow, what a strike from them. Karachan. Absolute turnaround at half-time.
15 unbelievable minutes for Reading. They're unlucky they're not level. It's their corner again. Ledgerwood. Long. Like kitten Swansea inside their own penalty area. Here's Joe Allen.
Well, ironic cheers there from the Reading fans. The Reading players are playing at a different pace now that they didn't play in the first half. A bit of zest to their play, passing crisper, they're doing everything quicker. As I said before, Swansea just need to slow the game down to start their passing, get their rhythm back.
Clearance from Tate picked up by Griffin. Reading have a man down on the edge of the Swansea penalty area at the moment. Andy Griffin has won a throw. Noel Hunt is the man who's struggling a bit, and Griffin might be told to just wait with this throw.
Phil Dow's just asking him if he needs any treatment. I don't think he'll want to come off at this stage.
Griffin, he's won a corner. All Reading.
The first half, he's not renowned for his skill, but showed a lovely little touch there and just shows what can happen.
Look at that. Reading's 12th corner of the game. Swansea haven't had one. All the noise is coming from Reading fans.
Oh, the most important stat is at the top of the screen, Steve. 3-2 for Swansea at the moment.
McInnes corner, driven in, out by Tate. Jimmy Kebe now for Reading. McInnes again, 5 in the middle. McInnes running at Joe Allen, can he beat him? Tries to go outside.
Oh, there was a chance. There was a chance there to deliver it. You can just see some of the Swansea boys furious with each other. What they need to keep composed, mark your man, encourage everybody just to stay nice and tight. Do not concede another now because of, well, you fancy Reading.
I don't think they can believe what they saw in the first half. And they certainly can't believe what they've seen in the second. Waste.
It is absolute waste, especially as you've got the momentum with you. I tell you, they've got a little chance if they go quick here.
Nathan Dyer can go quick, that's for sure. Chased by Mills, who, with a towering header, has sent real belief coursing through Reading legs. How many times have you seen the word believe around football crowds over the last month or so? Well, Reading believe in spades at the moment. Belief and confidence has sapped away from Swansea legs from the moment that Joe Allen scored that unfortunate own goal right at the start of the second half.
They're being rushed. I said before, if you press high up the pitch, you put players under pressure, it doesn't matter how good you are, we've seen it right at the top level, but everybody has to be committed to doing it. Good ball.
Jimmy Kebe trying to turn Ashley Williams, who's had a good game at the back. Playing non-league with Hednesford 8 years ago, Ashley Williams. That's a heck of a ball too. Well covered by Griffin.
There's a lot of these stories of players coming from non-league at the moment, and you know he's on the verge of the biggest stage of them all, isn't he? He can just hold on.
Nathan Dyer for Swansea. Joe Allen now for Swansea, trying to find Barini. Ledgerwood covering. Oh, it's a chance, is it? Barini couldn't quite dig it out. He's found Sinclair. Sinclair. Here's Anishvili with the interception. Long with Leon Britton. Won by Swansea midfielder Britton. Ran held to Joe Allen.
Oh, he didn't want it there.
Done well, beat Ranhel easily. Yes. Looked like he'd been having his shirt pulled by Prattley. Prattley's managed to work it back towards Gary Monk. DeVries with the clearance. Oh, Magic Wood was waiting for it, Prattley wasn't. Sinclair. Oh, Magic, of course, Sinclair.
I think that's a dive, you know.
And he's got the free kick.
Well, Phil Dowd seemed like he bought it. Matt Mills is furious. I think he pulls his leg back. Let's watch here. Pulls his leg back. If anything, Carrick, there's a slight touch, but Not sure. Back into dive.
Perini is addressing this ball as though he means business. Must be 30 yards out. He's played it into the path of Allen, who fired it straight into Ledgettwood.
I'm not sure it was the best pass to Joe Allen.
Just reached it.
That's better.
Hunt to long.
In the first half, they were doing that back to front ball from the right back to the forward. And they're giving it away a lot, and they're working through the midfield a lot better now.
Griffin. Ledgettwood. Joe Allen with it. Ledgettwood stayed on his feet. Two in the middle, and he just lost his composure at the crucial moment. It's a goal kick. And this was a chance.
Well, it was, yeah. Carrickham in midfield comes. It's a lovely strike, isn't it? Oh, it takes a little deflection. And that one there, that's a fantastic block. Lovely strike. Just takes deflection. Back up the post. And this one here, you just need to be a little bit lucky. Fantastic challenge.
Great, great block by Gary Munt. Could be a game saver, you never know. Well, Swansea can get some air in their lungs. Midway point of the second half.
It is very difficult to keep the tempo up as Reading have done. But they've seen what reward they've had for playing at a faster tempo and putting Swansea under pressure. It's great chasing.
De Vries Hall. Hart one ahead. Richard wants to touch on the carry to Burini. He's turned away from John Carriage on Burini. I'm sure would have been flagged offside had he chased the ball. He knew it too. Side flag up.
Not too sure he touched it, did he?
Do you think he's the chairman of Swansea City wondering will he be in with the elite next season? 25 minutes ago, it must have seen a wide open avenue to the Premier League. Now it's a crooked path with horrible crack paving stones to try and negotiate.
You know, the highs and lows of the football fan, and we've seen it here many, many times. And you know, I think when you're on the pitch as a player, it's easier. You just deal with what's in front of you, what's going on. You're trying to affect it, but with the fans, you know, head in hands, there's people around us who are crying on that second goal for Reading.
Ashley Williams for Swansea, looking for Nathan Dyer. And now Prattley for Swansea. He was reluctant to hit it with his left.
He was reluctant, but you know, I think if he just lays it there to Sinclair, just puts his heel on it, Sinclair can hit it with his right foot.
Swansea have a corner. Taken an hour and 10 minutes, it's their first. They still have the lead, though. Easy to forget amongst the huge storm that Reading have whipped up in the second half. Swansea still lead. Leon Britton. Joe Allen. Monk back to Britton. Dyer right back amongst the defenders. Oops, he's lost his footing. Got back quickly enough. Here's Joe Allen. Joe Allen again. Van Lanhel. Good ball. Perini taking on Kizanishvili. He's forced out of the box by the Georgian. Good play by Zurab Kizanishvili.
Good pressure from Swansea.
Joe Allen again. Actually trying to get around the in height. He's managed to squeeze across in. Kizanishvili with a little bit of help from John Karatek.
Looking for offside then. I thought it was.
And Reading have got a throw. Mm. Good tackle by Mills. Heels, that's for sure. They seem to have steadied themselves now. And Reading will have to muster up another storm.
Just now at the park, making them kick it back. They don't like to kick from the keeper, like to just throw it out.
Britton, 18 minutes to play. Tackle. Williams.
So, I think that comes on.
Miss Sinclair, substitutions will be afoot soon. But Jimmy Kebe now for Reading. Good pace. Still Kebe, still going. Hit Tate. Set off for the throw.
Just wondering if he's running out of steam. Jimmy Kebe. Been injured for a long while. They need to pick it up again, Reading, and drive. Because if not, then Swansea will allow it to go into the last 10 minutes where they'll take their time on everything.
Griffin with a cross, Ranghel with a clearing header. Helped out by Tate. Possessed at the crucial moment, Barini. Here's Kebe. Enough's in a good position if Kebe can pull it back. Oh, he put it over the top of all three. Legitwood. Good play, enough. Deflection.
Yeah, just see how important that was then. Legitwood just kept the ball in play there, and Dyer didn't respond. Allowed that ball to go in the box, and Makinoff ended up getting another corner. How is this?
Fourteenth corner kick of the game for Reading. Joby Makinoff. It's not the Reese's, and it is.
The centre-backs come up for that. The forwards are waiting for it.
Two substitutes still waiting to come on. Mark Gower for Swansea is one, and Simon Church for Reading is the other. Williams has given Monk a little bit of chasing to do. There. Still the substitutes wait.
It just keeps him really follow through, doesn't it?
Reading look like they're going to make their change. Simon Church is coming on. Noel Hunt makes way. Well, so Hunt off.
Yep.
Church on.
Playing some good service.
And Swansea are also going to make a change. Mark Gower will be on any moment, I think. So Mark Gower comes on and Leon Britton makes way for Swansea.
Message from the bench, isn't it?
Yeah.
All the subs know. Come on, let's lift ourselves.
Mills meeting the clearance with a really good header. Long to Kebe. Forward to Church, the substitute. Just come on. Shane Long. Trying to find Griffin, only found Sinclair.
Simple.
Gower, the other substitute forward, Kizanishvili to Griffin. Hart. Kizanishvili. Makanov. That was Gary Monk. To Karachan, to Kebe. Tate. Nathan Dyer's done well. He rather got his way, didn't he?
Did.
Shane Long. Ian Hart. That was difficult for Ledger, would you really get over?
I'm not sure from that distance. Well, from where Ian Hart put that ball in, it's easy to score from. Just think of when Ian Hart crossed that ball, he just slips it into.
It's 6,581 here today. Slightly less than the record for this fixture, 86703, when Hull beat Bristol City 3 years ago. Help. Dyer. Good ball. Ooh. Mills was just there, otherwise Perini was behind. Mills has given it away to Tate. Tate forward here. Tate looking for Perini. Oh. Griffin's challenge. It's a penalty. Griffin on Perini. Swansea have a second penalty.
Stonewall. Absolute stonewall penalty. Andy Griffin's thinking, I just do not know. Great play from Tate. Wrong side. Barini's going away from goal. Just stay still. Stand still. Let him go past you. It doesn't. He's not in. He's never going to score from that position. He's going away from the goal. Just stand still. Oh, dear. Great position from Phil Dow. No hesitation whatsoever. Stonewall penalty for all the hard work they've done to pull themselves back in the game. And that's a really poor challenge from an experienced player.
Not since Clive Mendonca in 1998 as a player scored a hat-trick in the Championship playoff final. More importantly, as Sinclair comes forward hoping to make it three for him, he might make it four for Swansea. He has! And Reading Storm just might have been blown out. Scott Sinclair for Swansea City, who are back on the brink of the Premier League. It's 4-2.
Well, it's something special to score a hat-trick at Wembley. He's an exceptional finisher, although to him the penalty doesn't matter. I was playing in the last game here when Clyde Mendonca scored one. And how crucial is that now? They've been pegged back the second half. They haven't played their best. And that just gives them just that bit more breathing space. Brendan Rodgers didn't even take his hands out of his pockets to applaud it. Congratulations.
A hat-trick at Wembley. That's what it looks like. Can Reading find the energy to do it all over again? They need two more goals.
I do. I mean, I said it's very difficult to keep the pressure up in the second half at the pace they stayed. They started at. You know, that's the second hat-trick of his career, and what a place to score one. And what an important game as well.
Griffin, so experienced. He'll rue the day.
Absolutely. I mean, just, you know, as players, you go in at the end of the game, whatever, and you ask, what did you do? And you just don't know. It's just one of those things. People put the ball, people handball in the penalty area, pull people back. It's just one of those things you do.
Jimmy Kebe's got a free kick here. He was pulled back. I think it's Mark Gowan. I think it's going to be a yellow card. The inflatable hands are flying, but in comes the Reading free kick. McEnough. Long ball to the back post.
That's a corner.
Oh, Joe Allen, he put it behind.
It was. He's not another own goal, does he? Mm. Good covering though. Nice deep cross. You can see everyone's queued up at the far post. He's down the ball.
It's a handy lead to have, 4-2. In comes the Reading corner. Out it goes from Joe Allen. Karachan. McEnough, Jimmy Kebe, four in the middle. McEnough, can he? Blocked by Williams.
Oh, good closing. See, the nearest man goes to the ball. Actually, Williams, the centre-back.
Jimmy Kebe. Sinclair, it's happened exactly how he dreamt it. Yeah. Swansea have a free kick.
And the emotions they've endured today, going three up, back to 3-2, and it could have gone any way then. And to get that fourth, which is, in football terms, it's the killer one.
Andy Griffin makes way.
Sean Cummings in there.
It's Hal Robson-Kanu who has come on to replace him. Defender in Griffin, replaced by attacking midfielder in Robson-Kanu. Legit Wood has failed to keep the ball in play.
That's an amazing story for Connor, isn't it? I think He's had two crucial knee ligaments at 22 years old, so nice one to get a taste at Wembley.
Was booked earlier. Ashley Williams forward for Swansea City. Nathan Dyer. Blocked from Noel Hunt's shot. It was one of the big moments of the game after Karachan's drive had bounced back off the post. Ashley Williams. Nathan Dyer. Mark Gower. Tate. Reading have a throw, but they have an enormous amount to do in a very short space of time. High towards Robson Kanu, and taken well by De Vries. There's never been a Welsh side in the Premier League. Swansea City dropped out of the top flight in 1983. Jimmy Kebbe for Reading. Lazy dribble still going. Took two or three to stop him in the end. Crackley did enough. Here's Sinclair, he's lost it. Ian Hart now for Reading. He wants it on his left if he can get it there. And he's won a throw.
It's absolutely pouring down now. All or nothing. Ball into the box, give themselves a chance.
And the challenge is possessed.
I can't understand why you don't cross it from the position you're in. Giving away free kick. You're trying to dribble past two or three players. You're 10 yards outside the 18-yard box. You just shake that ball into the box.
There's the man who took Swansea City to the top flight all those years ago. What a team they had. Leighton James and Alan Curtis and Ray Kennedy.
Yeah, played some good stuff then, didn't they? He looks a little bit more relieved now, doesn't he?
Well, the money is huge, of course, but it's not about money, it's about glory and status. Swansea City are heading to the top. Jimmy Kebbe. Reading have a throw, but even if they get one, they will need another. Well, Ashley Williams here.
I think he feels his elbow by Shane Long, you know. And Phil Dell was quiet on it, and vented his anger towards the referee, and we haven't seen one play. We've heard that Jay Tab got sent off at half time. Right arm, just at the side of the head.
Thought for a minute Phil Dowd was going to book him, but he hasn't.
Yeah.
So Luke Moore's coming on for the last few moments, and Joe Allen will make way, relieved that in the long run it doesn't look like his own goal will make any difference. Moore, who's played in the Premier League before.
Started at the Villa, didn't he? Went to West Brom.
Yeah. For many of these Swansea players, it'll be a new experience. unless Simon Church with the header.
Well, you know, people talk about the money all the time, Steve, about what does it mean, and obviously Reading have been there in the past, and but you know, for the players, no one ever talks about the money when you build up to these games. It's just the importance of going to the stadiums like, you know, the Emirates and Old Trafford, Chelsea. They're the important things to talk about. The motivation to get there, to play against the best players in the world.
Still trying, Reading. Robson Carney's ball into the box. Goalkeeper under all kinds of pressure here, De Vries. He did well to get anything on it. Nathan Dyer. Ledgerwood for Reading. Shane Long, Jimmy Kebbe. Charging forward, De Vries chose to punch. Ledgerwood.
Good defending. Look at how many, all the Swansea players back behind the ball.
Oh, well, McEnough has lost it. And here's Nathan Dyer for Swansea.
Good play.
Trackley. And Barini. And seconds away into the four added minutes. He's played one of them. Barini's on a throw. Celebrations are starting amongst those clad in black and white. Mark Gow for Swansea, Tate, Nathan Dyer, behind Simon Church. Mills with the forward header, the Reading captain. They'll have to pick themselves up and go again next season in what looks like being a hugely competitive championship. Brighton and Southampton will add to it. West Ham, Birmingham and Blackpool will add to it. My goodness me, what a division that's going to be next season. Incredibly difficult to get out of. Swansea won't have to worry about that. All they have to worry about is staying in the one above. Ledgerwood. Ian Hart. Mills, Reading almost out on their feet here. Simon Church. The umpteenth Reading corner. Corner counts are immaterial. 4-2 is what counts. Ian Hart with this corner kick for Reading. Three header over the top of the bar by Ledgerwood. That was a chance.
Absolutely. Over everybody. Three header. It's material now. It's far too late in the game.
Reading's fifth go at the playoffs. They've never been promoted through them. It's the same old story.
Well, coming into the game, I just had a sneaking feeling for Reading. You know, someone beat Cardiff, and although Swansea play, you know, the better football, I just thought that, I just felt that they had the balance of the team right. So, it's been an entertaining game. I thought there'd be goals.
There've been goals, all right. Scott Sinclair scored three of them. Swansea scored four. And Swansea City are the first Welsh representatives in the Premier League. And the celebrations begin. Swansea City are in the top flight for the first time since 1983. And for Reading, who gave us an unbelievable second half, it's the same old story yet again. Playoff pain as the opposition celebrate.
There's been some classic games here in this final, and it just seems to produce them in the Championship playoff. And I thought Swansea were fantastic in the first half, and that's where all the damage was done. It's very difficult to pick yourselves up in the second half, but Reading gave it a really good go. Brendan Rodgers there just commiserating some of the Reading players. And you'd have to say one of the most experienced players on the pitch, never mind in Reading's team. You know, made a challenge that really changed the outcome of the game. The late penalty in Andy Griffin. It is an incredible feeling. I mean, I've played in cup finals and gone on to lose them, and you know, I've played in a playoff game and won, and it just feels like, you know, you have won the FA Cup. The feeling of all your hard work right the way through the season, it matters, it means something. Because next season, you look so forward to the fixtures coming out. When are we playing Manchester United? When are we playing Arsenal? When are we playing Chelsea and Liverpool? You know, when are we going to Anfield? When are we going to the Emirates? They're the things you look forward to. And for the opposite end, obviously you'd always have to be a loser. But to start the season again in the Championship, and as you quite rightly said, a tougher league next year.
Swansea City will be at Stamford Bridge, they'll be at the Emirates, they'll be at Eastlands, at Anfield, at St James's Park, at Old Trafford. From Wembley Stadium, the venue of legends, they can look forward to a game at the Theatre of Dreams, because the side from the land of my fathers are heading to the top flight. It's Swansea City who've beaten Reading.
The same minded for him, Brendan Rodgers, who was sacked by Reading. Now, would it be a revenge mission? No, not at all. Yes, of course, he wants to win, he wants to take his team into the Premier League, but I think it's the brand of football, the style of football that they played with. You know, the players talked about him at Chelsea when he left there and took his first job to Watford. I mean, he's just, they play great football, they play really, really good football. Very similar to Blackpool last year, Steve. All in front of the next year. Less time to prepare for the biggest challenge of their lives, really, the Premier League. Signings have got to come in. Preparation needs to be done. And I think, I'm quite right in saying, Brendan Rodgers is going to Kilimanjaro, isn't he, for a charity hike, which I don't think there's any phone signals out there. It's not going to be easy to recruit, so... Oh, great scenes, great scenes.
Well, they did finish third in the Championship, Swansea City. And it seems perhaps appropriate that the team that just missed out over 46 games should be the team that goes up in the playoffs. But that is of no consolation at all to Reading. Nor is it really the time for sobering statistics, but six of the last eight playoff final winners have been relegated the following season. Only Hull City and West Ham have avoided that in recent years. Hull lasted only two seasons. West Ham lasted six until they went down this season. Of the last 20 Championship playoff winners, only Blackburn, Bolton and Wolves will be playing in the Premier League next season. Staying there is even harder than getting there. But what a joy it is to get there.
Is he ready for the agents calling? Rather be in the Premiership and have the hassle of everything than not be.
No place for runners-up. Reading have to stand and watch. A long, long walk up the steps. But not if you've just been victorious. Swansea City now take the route taken only 48 hours ago by Iniesta and Xavi and Messi and the rest. And Gary Monk strides forward. With every golden victory comes a silver trophy, and with this trophy comes a challenge to everyone from the chairman of the club to the youngest apprentice at the club. A challenge to be the very best that they can be, because as of this moment they are in with the very best. Wearing t-shirts commemorating a young member of the playing staff who died last year at the club. Swansea City are in the Premier League. The gauntlet is thrown down as the trophy is lifted up. Wales have a side in the top flight, and it's Swansea City. Thank you.
Thank you.